Hello friends, Sanjay Purohit from Sankey Study Center. Today would like to see question answer of animals written by Walt Whitman. You can see my video from Poem and Poetic Devices as well. But ye mera new venture hai. Some of the question answer we would like to discuss. The students who unable to understand language of the question answer from camp or whatever the other material they are using. Main aapka pehla question lunga. Mention three things the humans do and animals don't. The poet has drawn three comparisons between humans and animals. Three comparison. What are they? Human sweat, matlab ke working hard, sweat and work to make a living, and later whine and sulk about the amount of work they have to do to survive. अपने सर्वाइवल के लिए अर्निंग करना जरूरी है. नाउ एनिमल्स क्या करते हैं, तो कंपैरिजन हुई, अब एनिमल्स की बारी. एनिमल्स ऑन द अदर हैंड डू नॉट वाइन और रोमिंग अबाउट देयर कंडीशन. ह्यूमन लाई अवेक एट नाइट एंड क्राई फॉर द रॉन्ग्स दे हैव डन. एनिमल्स डू नॉट वीप फॉर एनीथिंग दे डू एंड स्लीप पीसफुली. इनको इंसोम्निया या तो कोई डर ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता. फाइनली ह्यूमन मेक्स ईच अदर सिक बाय डिस्कसिंग देयर ड्यूटीज टू गॉड. हाउएवर एनिमल्स डोंट हैव एनी गॉड एंड दे लिव एंड सर्वाइव विदाउट एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रेयर्स एंड फास्ट. तो अगर वापिस से हम लोग देखें तो क्या फर्क है. पोएट हैज ड्रॉन थ्री कंपेरिजन बिटवीन ह्यूमन्स एंड एनिमल्स. ह्यूमन स्वेट and work to make a living, and then or later whine and sulk about the amount of work they have to do to survive. Animals on the other hand do not whine about their condition. Human lie awake at night and cry for the wrongs they have done. Galat kiya uska pashchatap. Animals don't weep for anything they do and sleep peacefully. Finally human make each other sick by discussing their duties to God. However, animals do not have any God and they live and survive without any prayers or fast. Dusra question hai, do humans kneel to other humans who lived thousands of years ago? Discuss this in group. Ye main aapko ek hi baar bataunga. Question wapis se, do human kneel to other human who lived thousands of years ago? Discuss in their group. तो यूजुअली हम लोग जो आगे की चर्चा करते हैं, फॉर फादर, राइट, एंशियंटनेस एक्सेट्रा. यस, ह्यूमन नील टू अदर ह्यूमन हु लिव्ड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ इयर्स एगो. दे वर्शिप देयर एंसेस्टर एंड प्रे बाय नीलिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ देयर पोर्ट्रेट्स. उनके फोटो, उनके पोर्ट्रेट्स के सामने नील डाउन होके हम लोग प्रे करते हैं. दे होल्ड रिलीजियस सर्मन्स and ceremonies in their memory. तो religious sermons और उनकी ceremonies, उनकी memories में हम लोग करते हैं. और एक अच्छा question है, what are the tokens that the poet says he may have dropped long ago and which the animals have kept for him? Discuss this in class. Hint दिया है, Whitman belongs to the romantic tradition that include Rousseau and Wordsworth, which hold the civilization has made human false to their own true nature. What could be the basic aspect of our nature as living being that human choose to ignore or deny? Let's have a look at this. First of all, the token ka matlab wo token dete hai wo nahi hai, ya representation ya to manifestation hota hai. To ab answer dekhte hain. The tokens ya to representation ya to manifestation that the poet says he might have dropped long ago and which the animals have kept for him is his true nature as a human. While humans came close to civilization, they gradually moved away from their true nature. Natural instinct that human had and the innocence with which they lived and helped each other have been left behind somewhere. वो हम लोग छोड़ के आए हैं, पहले जो अपना नेचर था, हेल्पिंग नेचर, वो सब. एज दे गॉट नियर सिविलाइजेशन they choose to leave behind virtues of kindness, जो अपना एक वर्च्यू था, सद्गुण था, sincerity, unselfishness, joy, satisfaction, respectability and sharing. ये सब वर्च्यूज, अच्छे सद्गुण हम भूल गए हैं. They took to vices, वर्च्यू का अपोजिट है vices, such as greed, selfishness, desire to capture everything and other such inhuman characterize, जो हम लोगों ने कैप्चर किए. Animals have carried forward the real instinct and characteristic which the poet looks at and try to remember where he had negligently lost his true nature. Animals ने अपना true nature छोड़ा नहीं है, जबकि हम लोग अपना true nature छोड़ चुके हैं already. अब कुछ additional question हम लोग देखने वाले हैं, वो खास सुनना, right? पहला additional question है, why does the poet like animals? Poet को animals क्यों पसंद है? The poet like animals for their self-contained and quiet nature. The fact that animals are not like human beings and satisfied with their lives appeal to the poet a lot. आप इसमें समझाता हूं. Poet like animals, one, for their self-contained and very quiet nature. अगर वो अटैक करते हैं तो अटैक नहीं माना जाता है, right? The fact that animals are not like human being and satisfied with their lives, right, or with their lives, appeal to the poet a lot. अपनी तरह greedy नहीं है, जो मिला whatever they find they satisfied with that. अब दूसरा question, explain the satisfaction that animals have and humans don't. उनको जो सेटिस्फेक्शन है और हमको नहीं है वो देखो. एनिमल्स डोंट हैव द डिजायर टू पजेस वर्ल्डली थिंग्स, ये मेरा है वो तेरा है, उनको ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. वेयर एज द मोर ह्यूमंस ओन द मोर देयर डिजायर टू ओन ग्रो, जितना मिलता है उनकी डिजायर और स्ट्रांग हो जाती है कुछ नया लाने की. लिविंग देम डिससेटिस्फाइड फॉर एवर, द एब्सेंस ऑफ दिस ग्रीड इन एनिमल्स keep them satisfied and its presence keeps human dissatisfied. Very simple. Animals don't have the desire to possess worldly things, whereas the more human owns, the more their desires to own grow, leaving them dissatisfied forever. The absence of this greed in animals keep them satisfied and its presence keeps human dissatisfied. Human being right from the beginning very greedy and dissatisfied, aisa mana jata hai. Why do animals not weep for their sins? Un logon ne agar kuch paap kiya hai to wo rote kyun nahi hai? Animals do not weep, ya to cry ya to lament for their sins because they don't need to do so. Kyunki wo purposely nahi karte apne khane peene ke liye kisi ko marte, warna kisi ko hairan pareshan nahi karte. They are innocent creatures that commit no sins. It is human who weep yet commit sins. Rone dhone ke baad bhi sins to karte hi hai. So I repeat, animals don't weep for their sins as they don't need to do so. They are not doing any deliberately, purposely, intentionally. They are innocent creatures that commit no sins. It is humans who weep yet commit sins. और एक अच्छा क्वेश्चन है, व्हाट मेक्स द पोएट सिक? द फैक्ट दैट ह्यूमंस कमिट ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ सिंस एंड स्टिल डिस्कस देयर ड्यूटी टू गॉड मेक्स द पोएट सिक, ये परेशान उसको करता है. दिस शोज द हाइपोक्रेसी, एक फॉल्स शो, एक फेनिंग, एक उसके मुंह पे एक हाइपोक्रेसी आती है ऑफ ह्यूमंस who on one hand do wrong and the other pray to God. एक तरफ wrong करते जाते हैं और दूसरी तरफ भगवान को right उसका प्रसाद चढ़ाते रहते हैं कि मैंने ये किया, 11 नालियाँ चढ़ाऊंगा, ऐसा sins करते हैं, pray to God और एक तरफ sins भी commit करते हैं. वो poet को अच्छा नहीं लगता. The fact that human commits all kinds of sins and still discuss their duty to God makes the poet sick. This shows the hypocrisy of human who on one hand do wrong and on the other hand pray to God. अब एक और अच्छा क्वेश्चन है. Differentiate between humans and animals in terms of desire. In terms of desire, वो देख लीजिए. Animals are very different from human, as they have no desire to own things. उनको कोई डिजायर नहीं होती कोई चीज अपनी बनाने की. They are happy without an unending greed, while humans become maniac in their greed for possessing valuable things. आप इसे सुनो. Animals are quite different from human, as they have no desire to own any things. They are happy without an unending greed, while humans, on the other hand, becomes maniac. एक उनका right मनोवृत्ति ऐसी है maniac in their greed for possessing valuables. और एक question देखते हैं sorry. What does the poet mean by not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth? What does the poet mean by not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth? The poet means that animals do not pray to God or to ancestor and all of them are equal. Koi bada nahi, koi chhota nahi. Hence, no one is more respectable than the other. Equally respect. The good values of animals and lack of social conventions make them happy. कि मैं बड़ा वो छोटा, उनकी इनकम ज्यादा उनकी इनकम कम, वो गरीब वो और ये जाति का ये पाति का, सब कुछ नहीं होता. I repeat, the poet means that animals don't pray to God, to ancestor, and all of them are equal. Hence, no one is more respectable than the other. The good values of animals and the lack of social convention make them happy. तो यहाँ पे कुछ कुछ एडिशनल क्वेश्चन खत्म हुए, फिर भी कुछ लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन आंसर्स देखते हैं, राइट? तो एक और क्वेश्चन देखते हैं. व्हाई डू यू थिंक द पोएट हैज कॉल्ड द डिजायर टू ओन थिंग्स अ मैनिया? इज द पोएट राइट इन डूइंग सो? राइट योर ओन व्यूज. अब हमको अपने व्यूज बताने हैं. द पोएट यूजेस वर्ड्स such as demented, मतलब crazy, पागल, insane, demented, and maniac, जो crazy होते हैं, for never-ending desire of human being to own things. थोड़ा मिला और ज्यादा के लिए greed करते हैं. This word shows that poet is comparing this desire to madness, to craziness, to insaneness. The poet stands right in doing so, as this desire makes us so greedy and trap, किसी को trap में लेते हैं, trap us in a vicious circle, एक poisonous circle के चुंगल में हम लोग फंसे जा रहे हैं, of aspiring, मतलब कि kind of ambition, more and more. Animals that are free from any possession, इसको कोई चीज own नहीं करनी होती है, are also free from sins, उन लोग कोई पाप नहीं करते, worries and complain, उनकी कोई worries नहीं होती है, कोई fear नहीं होता है, और कोई complain नहीं होती किसी की ओर. In order to gain more wealth, all the important values such as morality and kindness are left behind by human being. By human being are doing so for greed, to earn a livelihood, to earn a money, right? ये सब विशियस सर्कल में आ गए हैं, जबकि एनिमल्स को ऐसा कुछ ओन करना ही नहीं है. और एक क्वेश्चन है, हाउ आर एनिमल्स सुपीरियर टू ह्यूमन बीइंग? अच्छा क्वेश्चन लग रहा है. हाउ आर एनिमल्स सुपीरियर टू ह्यूमन बीइंग? द एनिमल्स आर प्लेसिड, बहुत अच्छा वर्ड है, राइट? दे आर प्लेसिड, मतलब के काफी काम एंड क्वाइट, राइट? काम एंड क्वाइट, अनडिस्टर्ब, सेल्फ सफिशियंट, अपने ऊपर ही डिपेंड करते हैं और सेटिस्फाइड है, कॉम्प्लेसेंट एंड सिंपल. वो कॉम्प्लेसेंट मतलब कि कभी कोई चीज के लिए ऐसा नहीं कि भाई हम लोग बावरे हो जाते हैं. Unlike human, they do not worry about their conditions and sins, nor do they make others sick, discussing their duty to God. कि मेरे भगवान है, ये तेरे भगवान है, ऐसा भी कोई डिस्कशन नहीं होता है. They are not demented, पागल नहीं है, insane नहीं है, crazy नहीं है, mad नहीं है. They are not demented with the mania, या तो craziness, of owing things, कोई चीज को हासिल करने के लिए पागलपन बन जाते हैं, पागलपन का दौरे पड़ते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है. So they are superior to humans. तो इसको शॉर्ट में देखे तो they are placid, self sufficient, complacent and simple. Right? They do not worry about sins and conditions, nor do they make others sick, discussing their duty towards God. They are not demented with mania or owing the things that human beings generally do. That's why they are superior. Why does Walt Whitman feel more at home with animals? Unko aisa kyun lagta hai, unke inke saath kyun intimacy ya to more nearer lagta hai, to dekhte hain. Animals are placid, very calm and quiet and self-contained. They worry neither about their condition nor about their sins. Wo kabhi worry nahi karte. They are not dissatisfied, respectable, unhappy, or demented with the mania of owning things. They show their relations with the poet. So the poet Walt Whitman feels more at home with them. इसलिए उनको इनके साथ अच्छा लगता है. And last question, very important one. What is the central idea of the poem Animals? अगर कोई भी question answer हो, इसमें से आप थोड़ा बहुत लिख सकते हो. Very important one. ध्यान से सुनिएगा central idea of the poem. Walt Whitman wants to tell us that humans have become complicated and false. वो आजकल complicated और false हो गया है. Point one. Number two. They have forgotten their true nature. वो अपना original nature भूल गए हैं. Second point. They have forgotten their true nature. Number three. They want to earn more and more, so that they can own more and more luxurious commodities. कोई बहुत सारी चीजें खरीद सके. They do sins in order to earn, then they repent. Repent मतलब पश्चाताप करना, remorse, repent, feel guilty. Their sins have made them restless. उन लोगों की अपने कमिटमेंट ऑफ सिंस की वजह से वो रेस्टलेस हो गए. Humans trouble their companion discussing their duties to God, and on the other hand, animals are free from all types of trivial, मतलब के तुच्छ, ट्राइफल बोलते हैं ना, इसका प्लूरल फॉर्म है, trivial anxieties, so they are still living their natural life. So all the students, I tried my best to give you all question answers. If you like this, you can share and subscribe my channel. You can give this particularly question answer video to your friends as well. Thank you very much. Bye. Sanjay Purohit from Sankey Study Center. Goodbye.